Hi everyone, this is Dr. Shobha Shankar, professor in the Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering, Vidyavadhaka College of Engineering, Mysore. So far in the previous sessions, we have seen economic load dispatch or economic generation scheduling for the cases, namely without losses and with neglecting limits, second with limits, and third with transmission losses. And we have also seen the transmission loss formula. So in this session, we will take up unit commitment. So wherein it's a computational procedure to determine the number of units in the system which needs to be operated in order to meet the specified load. So in this session, we will see what is unit commitment. So it is a procedure to find out the number of units which must be committed or operated in order to meet the specified load. And we will also ensure that the cost of generating the power with these units would be economical. So we know that the total load in the power system varies throughout the load, and it reaches different peak from one day to another. And different combination of generators are to be connected in the system in order to meet this varying load. So when the load increases, the utility or the operating engineer should decide in advance the sequence in which the generator units are to be started. Similarly, when the load decreases, the operating engineer should also know in advance the sequence in which the generating units are to be shut down. So in unit commitment, it is not economical to run all the units available all the time. So we need to determine the units in a given plant that should operate for a particular load. And this is called unit commitment. So this problem is important for thermal power plants because the operating cost and startup time are very high, and hence their on-off status is important. A simple approach to the problem is to impose priority ordering, wherein the most efficient unit is loaded first and then followed by the less efficient units in the order as the load increases. So this is in case of priority ordering. A straightforward but time-consuming way of finding the most economical combination of units to meet a particular load demand is to try all the possible combinations of the unit that can supply the specific load or the specified load, and divide the load optimally among the units of each combination by the use of economic dispatch. So in economic dispatch, we are finding the most economical operating cost for the combination. And lastly, determine the combination which has the least operating cost among all these. So these combinations can be solved by the use of dynamic programming method. So in a practical problem, the unit commitments must be decided over the complete load cycle. So consider a plant which has 4 units and has to supply 100 megawatt. So the unit commitment problem solution yields the units which have to be operated to meet the specified load at most economically. So this is determined by the production cost of each unit. So if the load changes to 150 megawatt, then the unit commitment decides the new set of units to be committed. So this involves not only the production cost, but also the transition cost, which are associated with changing from one combination to other due to startup and shutdown cost of the unit. So the startup cost of a unit depends on how long the unit has been shut down after its last operation, whereas the shutdown cost is constant and does not depend on how long the unit has been running. So assuming that in a plant there are K units and they are always on the load, and at least one unit must be on to supply the system load. If each unit has to be considered on or off, then there are 2 to the power k minus 1 combination of units, which needs to be searched to determine the most economical combination. So in dynamic programming, the following assumptions are made. So wherein the first one, the individual production costs are known in advance for all the units, and the load cycle is also known in advance, and the load on each unit changes in small steps. Let us consider a plant with 4 units which has to supply 4 megawatt, and the load varies in step sizes of 1 megawatt. So given the production cost of all the units, the unit commitment problem can be solved as follows. So wherein in step 1, let us consider only 2 units arbitrarily which would be committed, and we will determine the most economical combination for all the discrete load levels. So since we are assuming that only units 1 and 2 are committed, we have the following options to supply for the 4 megawatt. So unit 1 supplies 4 megawatt and unit 2 0 megawatt. Second, unit 1 supplies 3 megawatt and unit 2 would supply for 1 megawatt. Third, unit 1 supplies 2 megawatt and unit 2 supplies 2 megawatt. Fourth, unit 1 supplies 1 megawatt and unit 2 supplies 3 megawatt. And lastly, unit 1 would supply 0 megawatt with unit 2 supplying the complete 4 megawatt. So we have combination of these. So for each combination, we are going to determine the cost of producing 4 megawatt, and we are going to choose the combination which would yield the lowest cost. Similarly, we can determine the best option for supplying 3 megawatt, 2 megawatt and 1 megawatt with 2 units. In step 2, the third unit is now committed. Now, to meet the 4 megawatt, we have the following combinations. So we have unit 1 and 2 together supplying 4 megawatt and unit 3 with 0 megawatt, or unit 1 and 2 supplying 3 megawatt and unit 3 with 1 megawatt, and so on. So previously in step 1, we started with unit 1 and 2 and we wanted to find out for this combination of 2 units, how are we able to meet the load of 4 megawatt and what would be the cost for that combination, and we are interested in finding out the combination which would yield the lowest cost. Whereas in step 2, now along with unit 1 and 2, we are also clubbing unit 3, and for this combination, we will find out how economically we can supply the load of 4 megawatt at least cost. In step 3, the fourth unit is now committed, and the process is repeated as in step 1 and 2 to find out the optimum production. Thus, having obtained all the optimal way of loading the units, it is used now to determine the loading of k plus 1 units. So the mathematical formulation of the above problem is as follows. So we are finding out a cost function fn of x is the minimum cost in rupees per hour or dollar per hour for generating x megawatt with n units. That is, let us say if we have f2 of 10 is the minimum cost of generating 10 megawatt with 2 units. And second, we have fn of y, it is the cost of generating y megawatt with only nth unit. That is, example, f2 of 10 is the cost of generating 10 megawatt by only the second unit. So therefore, by the use of dynamic programming, it results in a recursive relation. That is, fn of x is equal to minimum of fn of y plus fn minus 1 of x minus y. So wherein here, x megawatt are generated by totally n units. Out of these, y megawatt is generated by the nth unit at a cost function of fn of y, and x minus y megawatt is generated by the other n minus 1 units. So from this recursive relation, we are able to determine the combination of units which yields minimum operating cost for various loads starting from the smallest unit. So let us now consider a simple example in order to understand this dynamic programming method. So let us say we are interested in finding out the most economical units to be committed for a load of 8 megawatt if the load step is 1 megawatt and there are 4 units in the plant. The cost curve for any unit at a generation level is given by the fuel cost function Fi being equal to Ai plus Ai Pgi square plus Bi Pgi rupees per hour. The coefficients A and B are given in the below table 1 for various units. And transition costs are neglected. So we have 4 units which should supply for 8 megawatt. So in a load step size of 1 megawatt. So in step 1, we are interested in computing the cost of generation for each unit in steps of 1 megawatt. That is, we are interested in calculating what is Fi of Y for Y varying from 1 to 8 megawatt and I is varying from 1 to 4 megawatt. So we have 4 units which can supply a load of 8 megawatt starting from 1 megawatt. So here we have shown only for the first plant, first unit alone supplying for 6 megawatt. So wherein we have the fuel cost function, using that function, we are able to calculate what would be the cost of generating this 6 megawatt only by unit 1. Similarly, we are able to complete this table, which is nothing but the cost of generation of the respective units, that is respective load level for the combination of 4 units, unit 1 or unit 2, unit 3 and unit 4. So we assume that 8 megawatt is generated by 1 unit. So given by the expression F1 of 8 being equal to that respective amount. Similarly, we are able to compute F1 of 7, F1 of 6, that is 7 megawatt would be produced only by unit 1 or 6 megawatt only by unit 1 and so on. So in step 2, we add unit 2 along with unit 1 and among the combination of unit 1 and 2, we are going to find out the optimum combination which would result in least cost. So this is previously in the table, we have taken only one unit and for that individual unit, it can produce or it can satisfy the load starting from 1 megawatt up to 8 megawatt. And accordingly, we have also found out what is the cost. Now, instead of one, we now go for combination of two units. For that combination of two units, again, we'll find out the best combination which would yield for least cost. And in step 3, we will now add unit 3. So how it goes on now? Along with step 2, wherein in step 2 already we have found out the combination of unit 1 and 2 which would yield the minimum cost, the best combination which would yield the minimum cost. Now we are adding to this combination unit 3. So now we have unit 3 along with combination of unit 1 and 2. In step 4, unit 4 is also committed. So unit 4 along with combination of unit 1, 2 and 3. So finally, we arrive at step 5. That is the final commitment is obtained by a simple backward step. And we say that we commit unit 1 and 2. And if we consider 1 as on and 0 as off, the combination for 8 megawatt is 1100. That means to say that if and only if unit 1 and 2 are operated with 3 and 4 being shut down, then it provides the best combination and it yields minimum cost. So we can prepare the unit commitment table for the complete load range. So there are 4 units for the total load range of 20 megawatt. So thank you.